Welcome to DIYeasycrafts.com, knife metal etching, the easy way. Now for this project, we're actually going to take a knife, one of the knives which I made. I was just never real happy with the final product. It just, the blade looked very, very dull, very plain to me, and I wanted to jazz it up. I figured it would be a good opportunity to test out, full blade metal etching. What I decided to do was to coat the blade with a transfer film, which I got from Michael's Arts and Crafts. I just cleaned the blade first with an alcohol wipe just to get off any grease. I made sure I then didn't touch it with my fingers before I applied this film. This film is a clear film. You just peel the back and apply it directly onto the blade. And just use my fingers. You could use a credit card or any flat surface, or just with your fingers. Just make sure there's no air bubbles. Squeeze it down firmly. I just used a straight razor to trim off the excess material. Just really just makes it a little easier to work with. And the whole goal here is to cover whatever areas that you don't want etched. So anything that we cut out, we're going to etch. I just drew a basic design, a wave design, onto this transfer film, and then I used a razor blade to cut out that design. A very simple, very easy process. Not the best artist, and I'm sure if I had a pointy arts and craft type razor knife, maybe I could have gotten a little smoother curves, but this little straight razor did a fine job. Once it's completely outlined, then I used a tweezer to get it started, and then I'm just pulling off the area that I want to etch. Now you definitely do want to cover the very edge of the blade. You don't want to etch very, very close or onto the actual edge of the blade, because that thin metal, that thin steel would get damaged by the etching. At this point, I wanted to add a little bit of additional details. So after I was finished with this transfer film, I actually borrowed a little bit of my wife's nail polish, and I ended up putting some dots of nail polish all over the rest of the blade. Now this is the part of the blade that's going to get etched, so that each one of these spots that's now covered with the nail polish will actually be a glossy area or an unetched area. I also did the edge, the spine. I protected the spine of the blade also with that same nail polish. All right, now it's time to head into the garage. I'm just using a 12-volt car battery charger. Now, normally you would etch a blade before you put on the scales or the handles, but this is kind of a last-minute thought for me, so I'm kind of doing it backwards. I attached the positive end of the charger. I was actually able to get a contact on the full tang over the handles. And then the negative, I just took a piece of gauze, wrapped it up real tight, and attached it to the negative end. I'm dipping this into a salt water solution. I mixed, they say about 2 tablespoons per a liter container of water. I actually didn't measure. I just poured a bunch of salt in there. Very carefully, I'm making sure that I don't touch anything metal with either one of my hands. I'm just holding the protective portion of each one of these clamps. I'm going to apply that gauze to each section of the knife as I work my way from the point down towards the handle. It takes a few seconds to get going, but this does build up some heat, and it does etch pretty quickly. I ended up doing 2 passes over the entire blade, and I spent about 10 to 15 seconds on each section all the way down, and then I went back again and spent another 15 seconds on each section. And you can always test to see how deep this engraving is just by washing down the knife with a little bit of water very, lightly with a paper towel, and you can just take your finger and scratch, and you can see how deep the etching has gone. So this is the second pass now. Again, this is just a salt water solution, a 12-volt battery charger. I actually have it on 50 amps. You can play around with different amperage depending on the type of steel you're using. This is a 1095 steel that I used. Almost done. And then after the etching's completed, the blade's going to look pretty messy. I used another piece of gauze just to rinse it off, wash it down a little bit. And if I didn't think it was deep enough at this point, I could certainly go back and etch it a little bit deeper. But at this point, it actually looks pretty decent. So you can peel that transfer film. That will give you an even better idea as to what the finished product is going to look like. To get the nail polish, those little spots of nail polish off the blade, I actually have to use some nail polish remover. And then that transfer film did leave some gummy areas. So after the nail polish remover, I did rub down the blade just with some paint thinner. Now, the etching still left that etched area very, very dark. What I did was I just repolished the blade with a 1500 grit emery paper. Just very quickly, lightly went over the entire blade, the etched area, as well as the non-etched area. And that's it. Very simple, very easy to do. And of course, you could design anything you wanted on here. Just your artistic ability go wild a little bit. But a very easy to do etching process that kind of enhances almost any very plain blade into something that's definitely not plain anymore. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please check us out on the web at DIYeasycrafts.com. If you like this video, I ask that you please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this YouTube channel.